Hey everybody, it's Monday, and that means it's time for more Popful Mail, or Popful Mondays, as I like to call it. Of course, I also upload videos on Wednesday and Friday, so I don't know what to call those days. I mean, obviously, I can't call those days Popful Monday, because, well, it's no longer Monday by that point. I'll workshop it. I'll come up with something. Maybe the 3 days can be themed around the three characters. Monday is Popful Monday. Wednesday is Tap Wednesday. And then Friday is Mystery Third Character Friday. It's Gaul. By this point, I'm sure everyone's figured out that the third character will be Gaul. And I mentioned it a few times as well. So I don't know why I'm pretending there was ever any kind of air of secrecy around it. Mail, Tat, and Gaul. That's your team. And let me tell you, it's a pretty motley crew. They are as different as night and day. And a third thing that's not night or day, but related to them. Afternoon. They're as different as night, day, and afternoon. Perhaps one of the reasons I like Tat so much is that I can identify with him. Kostya in the YouTube comments said that I remind him, or Tat reminds him of me. The way he is polite and politically correct, as he says it. I don't know if I would call myself politically correct. I'm not trying to specifically not offend anybody. I just want to be nice, you know? I mean, the internet and video gaming and Let's Plays in particular are so full of people who like to be snarky and, you know, mean to people. Maybe people who deserve it, maybe not, but the internet's full of that stuff. And I want my channel and my Twitch channel and my whole media empire to be a place where you can go for niceness. And I know that's why a lot of people have been drawn to me. And I think I like being known for that. I have tried a few times in the past to branch out into, you know, the snarky, mean kind of internet humor territory, but I don't know if it's really for me. Like in the last episode of Splatterhouse 2, which is now lost to the ages, I specifically tried for like an angry video game nerd vibe where I pretended to be, you know, really angry and upset, and I just don't think it's for me. Here we can buy Tat's Electrocane, which is the weapon I was talking about in a previous video that lets you... it's funny, it has a little icon of a hand down there because I don't have a weapon equipped, but the sprite is still holding the staff. Hitting the attack button just doesn't do anything now. Can you... Huh. Oh yeah, I guess you can unequip stuff. I don't know why you ever would. It's weird. So yeah, that's the Electrocane. You can make the projectile go up, make it go down. The projectile is a little slow, but usually that's not that important. Switch over to mail. Deal with the creepy shopkeeper again. I'm going ahead and sell my dagger since I won't need that anymore. And buy the boomerang. Excellent. How am I doing on fruit? I'm pretty good. 7 apples, 3 bananas. Wow. Prison key. Interesting. That's the boomerang. There are a few situations where it's specifically useful, but actually let's keep Popful Mail out. Well, I've been killing as many monsters as I can. Hey, who are you?
Strange to see you down here. Can God help?
I heard that you had captured Muttonhead. Where'd you take him?
God cannot tell. Big secret. Bad man. He tried to wake the sleeping giant. Are you a friend of his?
Friend? Who, me? How stupid do I look? I'm just after the huge bounty on his head. Get it?
Well, I still can't help you. He's too dangerous.
Are you sure? Well, if you say so. Well, we're at a dead end. That'll do it for Let's Play Popful Mail. Oh, wait.
Garadus?
Didn't you know? He's a giant monster that lives on Panic Peak but sleeps eternally. If Garadus awakes, God Cave will be wrecked. All gone, God. A magic man tried to wake Garadus, but God will never, never allow that to happen.
Damn it, voiced cutscene. You ruined my joke. It wasn't a very good joke, but still, it's the principle of the thing. If I tell, trouble to follow. Are you sure? Nice of them to give a bunch of different little dialogue windows there. Okay, so we can't go this way, so obviously we have to go find Muttonhead ourselves before we can progress in the video game. Luckily, I just happen to know the general way to Muttonhead. Let's save in case we get hit, which is still pretty likely. The weapon's pretty good though. The damage on it is pretty high. So yeah, like I was saying, I just like to be nice. I think I need to make a more concerted effort to be as nice as possible. Because I want that to be my thing. And if you don't like it, there are hundreds, nay, thousands of Let's Players out there you can go to watch them, you know. Be snarky. I was a little snarky about this game in one of the Borderlands streams. And, I think it was pretty clear that I was just joking. I do like this game, otherwise I wouldn't have started LPing it in the first place. It's weird and it has its little quirks, but darn it, it's just charming. The silly translation. Retro mechanics, let's say. Oh god. I don't like these bats nearly as much as the coffee bean bats. They're not as fun. Oops. Actually, I don't know if there's a reason for me to go up. There might be something up here. Oh, that bat respawned. Great. It is a tough game, but it's not. The difficulty can be overcome. It's not impossible. Is this where I came from? I think it might be. Okay. I need to keep going down in this area. That's the way to Muttonhead. I don't want to make this video too long, but we do have a couple of boss fights coming up. One right after another, almost. I don't want to make the next video just a boss fight, so I'll probably do both. Did I get... Nope, there he is.
Teacher, what happened? You just abandoned me.
Oh, Tad, it's a long story.
If you want to tell me, I'll listen.
I was offered a big reward to guard these caves for a very mysterious man. And well, seeing how I've got a price on my head, well, it seemed like a great place to hide out. But I guess I really underestimated the power and the resolve of these pesky flying blobs. They learned of my plans for the area and, well, they got kind of angry. Squat fools, they trapped me in my sleep! But they underestimate me! Only I control Garatus! I'll crush them when I get out of here!
Yeah, nothing wrong with you at all. I don't see why they threw you in here. And you had nothing else to say. Great. Okay, well, now that we talked to Muttonhead, we triggered the event that'll let us progress in the game. So let's head back to the little Gaul community. And the Gaul are kind of scattered around all over the place in here. There's the main Gaul village. There's that little Monster Mart area. There's this place. There's not even a sign or anything for this place. It's just a little pocket of Gaul in the middle of the hot springs. Which still doesn't look like a hot spring, by the way. Well, of course, this is no longer the hot springs area. This is Panic Peak. Looks similar, though. Except a lot more stalagmites and stalactites in the background. As opposed to the hot springs, which was waterfalls instead. I am liking this new weapon quite a bit. Still have two more slots for upgrades after this. And of course we still need to upgrade our current equipment. Which will be the next item shop we find, hopefully. So yeah, E3 pretty much wrapped up by this point. I have to say, I'm kind of excited. I'm still considering getting a PlayStation 4. I had a PS2 and I loved it. I skipped on the PS3 just because it was way too expensive and there weren't that many games I was interested in for it. But PS4, I don't know, looks intriguing. Having a Prozac moment. This bit of dialogue brought to you by the Pfizer Pharmaceutical Corporation. I think that's the company that owns Prozac. Wow, real cheerful bunch of guys.
This is the fool that caused Garatus to awaken. You know him, don't you?
Muttonhead?
I'm sorry, I don't understand. What are you talking about?
Your friend has awakened Garatus from his sleep. You must pay for his stupid actions.
Wait, awakened? What stupid actions? I'm afraid this is making less and less sense.
This fool! Yeah.
Aw, man.
Hi, guess what? And I know this is gonna make your day. I blew it again! Well, you see, there was this weird door in the cave, and I kinda thought that there was, well, treasure on the other side of it, you know? So I just blew the door off its hinges and, well, kinda woke up this giant. We're talking King Scyther, and he was pretty mad. So I just, ran. Then I tell Squirty here about it, and he goes ballistic on me. I mean, jeez! So then I said, hey, God, settle down, no worries. I know this hot magician that'll shred this Garatus dude to ribbons.
But
oh, thanks.
Mr. Slick.
Now that we're in this mess, you are the only hope for Gaw Cave. You must defeat Garatus. If you do, I'll be your friend forever.
Aw. Well, if you put it that way.
Hey, Tap, I got one last piece of advice for you.
Give him hell for the Slickster.
Whoa.
Mr. Slick, I will try hard to defeat Garadus, but in the meantime, please reevaluate your behavior.
Yeah, sure, Tat. I'll get right on it.
Oh, how do I get myself into these situations?
I love that. Reevaluate your behavior. That's totally something I would say. Let's see if Mail has anything to say to Slick. Same thing. What about you? Okay. Well, I guess if Gaul will be my friend and I get some gold bullion, it's all worth it. So yeah, we don't have Garadus yet. We have this weird mini-boss here. Let's go ahead and save. Trick to taking out this mini-boss. Well, it's not really a trick. It's just general advice. First of all, don't stand... Damn it. Well, good thing I saved. Don't stand under those miniature dragons because they'll do the lightning thing. And try to kill them first. Because it makes the guardian himself a lot easier to defeat. This is exciting. This is the point where I got up to in my original Let's Play Popful Mail video series. I had a I had an unfortunate accident where I killed this boss and died at the same time, which was really a bummer. And then shortly after that, before I could record another video, my computer died. So this is the turning point. Damn it. After this, it is 100% new content. I'm very excited. Hopefully you are too. Alright, one down. One more to go. I'm probably going to use some fruit just to get myself back up to 100%. After you take out the tiny dragons, the guardian himself is really easy to defeat, but there could still be a blunder. Alright, maybe not 100%, but I'll at least get myself up a little higher. Let's use a cherry. Oh, yep, that's 100. Okay, good. Let's wait for my staff to recharge. This boss fires bolts of electricity that not only damage you, but also prevent your weapon from charging for a little while. Once you kill the dragons, it's pretty much just a matter of staying as far to the left as possible while keeping the boss on the screen. Jumping and shooting. Back away, wait for my staff to recharge, rinse and repeat. Actually, this video is getting a little long. I think I will call it after this. And the next video, well, the next boss might take me a little bit longer than this one even. So, it might still be a pretty meaty chunk of content. Anyway, I kind of want to divide this here so you know that all videos after this are totally new. Unseen previously parts of Popful Mail. Well, unseen by anyone who's only been watching my my LPs. Kicked the Thunder Dragon's butt. Yes, I did. Man, I don't know how I had so much trouble with this boss in my previous videos. Anything nifty over here? Is that a door? No, it just kind of looks like one. A door in the background. Jump over here, grab this cherry. Replaces the cherry I just ate. And that's the door out. Let's go back and see what the townsfolk have to say. Any new advice? Well, yeah, it would kind of like an engraved invitation. The way to Panic Peak is now open. I know you can defeat Gradus. Well, let's find out. So yeah, this is exciting. I'll give you a little teaser of the next boss. Go ahead and save it. Save over this one. I posted a screenshot of this guy, since he is what comes right after the Guardian. Gradus appears. Alright, well, tune in on Wednesday and see if I can defeat Gradus. I should be able to. I've done it a few times before, but you'll just have to wait and see. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you later.